When you look at the Houston Rockets and you mention the names James Harden and Russell Westbrook, there's no question that a lot of animosity comes to your head. James Harden wants out, Russell Westbrook wants out. But what I will say, and I will give the Houston Rockets management and ownership credit, I think this signing of DeMarcus Cousins is one of the safest, cheapest, and best moves you can do to almost try to hold on to a James Harden or Russell Westbrook and kind of keep Harden happy. Because the goal is to keep Harden happy. We know they don't care about Westbrook, whether he goes, stays, what they want to do with him. They want to leverage him in trades, blah, blah, blah. But they want to keep Harden. We know that already. That's on record. But when you look at this team, they lost pieces, and they went the route with P.J. Tucker at center. I was never feeling P.J. Tucker playing center. Never was feeling that. I was always a Clint Capella guy. I love Capella. I love P.J. Tucker for his defensive prowess and his ability to play center. You see, this is a guy that can guard the 1-5. P.J. Tucker is an underrated defender. But at the same time, I don't want you playing center. You're undersized. You're slow. It's a no-go for me. And we've seen what happened to them in the playoffs. They suffered greatly when it came against the Lakers because you're going against AD, JaVale McGee, Dwight Howard. You're too small. Mind you can shoot, but that does not work out if your shots ain't dropping. But when you sign DeMarcus Cousins, to me, this is a big-time move. Now, I hear you. I hear the whisperings. He's hurt. He's always getting hurt. He's always getting hurt. He's always injured. Blah, blah, blah. Yes, we get that. But DeMarcus Cousins, when he's not hurt, when he's healthy, this is a 25-point game plus a night kind of guy. This is a 10-rebound plus a night kind of guy. It's no question that he's a terror on the court. He's a big-time problem. You have to game plan for DeMarcus Cousins. He can shoot the mid-range. He can shoot the three ball. He's a back-to-the-basket player. We're talking about old-school center right here with moves, post moves, spins, everything, hook shots. He will destroy you on that court. So there's a lot of upside to me. At the same time, I'm paying, what, a bullshit salary for DeMarcus Cousins for 1 year. I get Cousins for 1 year. And if he's healthy, it's a problem. We're talking Russell Westbrook, DeMarcus Cousins, James Harden. That's it. That's already a solid core. Going forward, they got to fill in the blanks. They lost Jeff Green. They lost, they lost Austin Rivers, backup guy. They lost a little bit of pieces, but those are guys you can fill in. A DeMarcus Cousins, you can't fill in. A James Harden, you can't fill in. A Russell Westbrook, you can't fill in. Now, Westbrook, going forward, all he needs to do is shoot just a little bit better. We're not talking about threes. You see, Westbrook gets caught up shooting the three ball. They say I don't criticize Westbrook. Westbrook gets caught up shooting the three ball. I don't want him shooting the three ball. Occasionally, you got to keep the defense honest. Occasionally, if he's wide open, and he's an NBA player. He can make a spot set three-point shot. But I want Westbrook to continue on that mid-range game. Get back to that old Westbrook. We're talking about that old aggressive Westbrook where you was playing off too much. He was going to the basket. When you was playing off too much, he was hitting the mid-range in your face. Easily. He's a mid-range monster. If you was playing too close, it's bye-bye. See you later. So when you got a DeMarcus Cousins who's a body bruiser in that paint, you got Westbrook going full speed because you know his game. It's inside the paint, kick it out to the shooters. But it's also dropping down to the centers. He made Steven Adams look beautiful. James Harden makes Tyson Chandler look beautiful. Do you understand what Russell Westbrook and James Harden will do with a player like DeMarcus Cousins? It's unfair. But when you factor in injuries, it gets fair. So we're looking at this on the bright side, on a high note. Because we understand that, there's a lot that's going into now. We got egos, we got chemistry, we get all of that. We're talking about on paper and using our eye test, the eye ability to see what a James Harden and a Russell Westbrook and a DeMarcus Cousins could do to you out there. That's a problem. Everything else is filling in the blanks. You see, I don't want this team should not be coming down and that run and gun shooting threes and within 10 seconds or 8 seconds within the offense. That Dan and Tony garbage was nonsense. Let's be honest. Dan and Tony wasn't a defensive guy. He's just all about offense and all about scoring. And I was not feeling his game style. Yes, they won. But you win because you have talent, too. A lot of coaches are overrated because they have great players. You know what I'm saying? It's one thing to say, I got Curry, Kevin Durant, Klay Thompson, Draymond Green, X's and O's, run this play. No. Look who you just named. Klay Thompson, Steph Curry, Draymond Green. You know what I'm saying? You name elite players. Kevin Durant, they don't have to do much on the court. They already got the game. They know what they're going to do. So your coaching ability to me in that sense is a little bit far-fetched. These guys are stars. They know what they're doing. But like I said, Cousins is a great fit and a great signing for that team because it's free. It's damn near free and it's cheap. You can't go wrong with it.